What's up, guys? It's Kelly, and today I've got another swatching review for you. Today I am partnering up with Lolli Polish, which is an international nail polish distributor, and I'm going to be doing a pretty massive swatching review for Bow Polish. If you haven't heard of Bow Polish before, I have reviewed them a few times, but they are a Russian nail polish brand that is vegan, they are cruelty-free, and they are also fine-free, meaning they are free of five of the potentially harmful ingredients that can be often found in nail polish. So I've got 10 polishes to go over today, including two new flash reactive polishes. So I actually did a review on their flash reactive polishes a little while back. I'll link it up in the cards, but it's basically just these super sparkly polishes that have a crazy reflective flash when you are using like the flash on your camera or even in the sunlight. So it's just a super bright, sparkly, fun type of glitter. It's kind of similar to, you know how like street signs at night, they like are very reflective. I think it's that pigment, but I'm not 100% sure. But I also wanted to share some swatches of the new to me shades I got. I've been really into thermals lately, so I picked up a bunch of thermals. I'm going to show you guys all of them. Thermal meaning that the polishes change color based on the temperature. So I'm going to be showing you by dipping my nails in hot and cold water, but it doesn't actually require water to change. If your body temperature is cold or hot, it's going to change with that as well. But yeah, so with the flash reactive polishes, I'm going to be showing you guys swatches in my regular lighting, but then I'm also going to show you with my phone flash just so you can see that crazy reflective pigment. That's really the best way that I could think of to show you guys how it actually looks. It's almost like cartoony in how sparkly it is. But yeah, let me just show you guys all of these swatches. So roll the footage. So as always with my swatch and review videos, I do like to use base coat underneath all of my swatches just to protect my natural nail and prevent any stains. This time it's the Orly Bonder base coat. So we'll start off with these flash reflective polishes. This first one is called No Rest, and it's a really juicy watermelony pink kind of jelly base that has these silver super reflective sparkles running throughout. And one thing I noticed about this immediately upon trying it is that this one felt a lot more opaque than the original reflective polishes that I tried from Bow a little while back. It actually gave me perfect coverage in two coats. Now do keep in mind I have short nails, so if you have long nails you might see a little bit of visible nail line, but I feel like this fully covered up mine in that second coat, and you can see even without my phone flash, it is just so sparkly and reflective. It really looks super beautiful. I would say it's a little bit more sparkly than this when I'm in the sunlight, but let me show you guys what it looks like with the camera flash, because that is where it gets really crazy. So please pardon the fact that I'm a little shaky here. I am doing this on my phone, and I do have a piece of construction paper underneath my hand, so that is what we're looking at here. But you can see this is like almost blindingly bright white glitters in here, and it looks incredible. So moving on to the second and final of the reflective polishes. This one is called Lime, which is a very accurate name for it. It's a really beautiful, almost neon lime green jelly. Again, it has those super reflective sparkles running throughout. And this one I was absolutely certain was going to be a three coater just based on the base color and how sheer it was in the first coat. But surprisingly, I actually managed to get this one opaque in two coats as well. Once again, you might need a third if you have longer nails than me, but I was just really impressed with the coverage in that second coat. Once again, with my direct lighting, it was still pretty sparkly. It didn't actually look as sparkly without the sun or without the reflective lighting, but it still had a nice amount of shimmer in here. But once I turned on my camera's flash, it just completely transformed. The actual reflective pigment in there is so bright that it actually looks like it makes the polish even more opaque. I don't know if that makes sense. I feel like looking at this footage, it almost looks cartoony, like not even real. It's just really impressive. So before we move on to all of the thermal color changing polishes, I actually also picked up this shade called Eternity, which is a really beautiful multi-chrome polish. And in addition to having that multi-chrome base, there's also little metallic flecks of glitter in here. The color shift actually goes from like blue to purple and then a bunch of other colors just depending on how you're moving your hand. But the really special thing about this I thought were all of those little flecks that catch the light really nicely. So when I started applying it, I realized that this polish is very sheer and it is also very thin. So at first I did three coats. That's what we're looking at right here. And I thought that that did give me full coverage. Out of curiosity, I did want to try a fourth coat, and this is the only time you will ever hear me say that I was interested interested in a fourth coat, but the polish itself is just so thin that even with the third coat, it felt like I maybe had two coats of color on my nails. So the fourth coat didn't really add that much in terms of thickness. It did, however, look better in four coats. But that being said, I mean, four coats is a lot to wear on your nails, so I really wanted to try this one over black as well. So here it is over black, and I feel like you get a lot more depth of that multi-chromatic color in there. You can see all of that gorgeous sparkle, and I feel like, if anything, the sparkle looks a little bit more pronounced over black, and you can just see there are honestly, I think, too many colors to even name in here. I'm wondering if it's, I don't think it's holographic, but it's just so colorful and beautiful, and you can really see that color shift between those two colors. So yeah, definitely liked this one over black. I might try it at some point on its own with four coats, but it doesn't seem like it's gonna happen anytime soon. Okay, so let's move on to the thermals now. This first color is called Mood Creator, and it's actually a tri-thermal, meaning that it shifts from cold to room temperature slash tepid to hot. So as you can see in the bottle, it was kind of that medium temperature, which was like a very dusty brick reddish base color. And as I was applying it on my nails, which were very warm at this time, it ended up shifting into this sort of taupe base color. And it also has a very subtle scattered hollow running throughout. But anyway, I am doing three coats of this one, and that's something that I've started doing with all of my thermals now, because you never know how light the other color is gonna be, and I feel like it's just good insurance to have a third coat on there just to make sure that there's no patchiness when your nails shift colors. So let's show some of this really crazy color shift. As you can see, on the left side I had my warm water, and on the right side I had my cold water. So when the polish is cold, it actually turns into this very deep, vampy maroon color. And as it fades into that room temp, it gets a little bit redder, and then it slowly fades into this taupey gray when it's warm. Moving on to the next shade, Heartbreaker, and this one is actually a pretty interesting slash unique one. It has this sort of pinky, orangey red base, and then in addition to that subtle scattered hollow, it also has these iridescent larger flakes running throughout, and I just think that is such a fun addition. I haven't seen that very often in thermals, so I thought it was really fun. And as it fades into that warm color, you can see it turns almost this white shade, and it really looks opalescent on the nails. So once again, I did do three coats. I actually felt like I only needed two for this one because there are so many flakes in there, but again, I just like to do that third coat just to make sure that everything is gonna look good once it transitions into the other colors. So once again, the left is the warm water and the right is the cold water, and it has this very vibrant strawberry red kind of color when it is cold, and this soft, almost white color when it is warm. So another really fun shift here. Next up we have Cross My Heart, and this is actually a very similar polish to Heartbreaker, but this is sort of the fuchsia version of it. So when it is in its cold state, it is this nice, intense fuchsia pink base. Again, it has that subtle holographic sparkle running throughout, and then it also has these larger iridescent flecks running throughout. And as you can see, as it shifted onto my warm nail, it does turn into a white color. And once again, I was just really into how opalescent the polish looked when it was in its warm state. And I think this one ended up being a little bit cooler of a white than the Heartbreaker shade, which was a little bit warmer on my nails. But yeah, let's play around with some water here. So you can see in that cold water, it turns into a very vibrant fuchsia shade. And then in the warm water, we get that nice cooler toned white. So very sensitive to the color temperatures, and it was changing a lot on my nails even without me dipping into the water, which I thought was really fun as well. Next up we have the shade Firestarter, which I feel like that name is kind of funny. I would expect it to be a red or an orange thermal, but this one is actually a pink when it's warm, and it shifts into a purple when it is cold. And this one actually has a really nice, almost subtle shimmer running throughout that has a little extra sparkle. So it's sort of this duochrome-y, orangey, golden shimmer, and then there's these slightly larger flecks in here. Now, because this one shifts from a medium color into a darker color, I actually was comfortable just doing two coats of it because I knew it wasn't ever gonna be like a very light shade on my nails, which would sometimes require a third coat. So I did end up doing just two for this. You can see when it is warm, it's that nice soft pink. And as it cools down, it becomes this really intense purple color. And I love the way the purple looks with that shimmer in there. It's hard because I was so hot at this point, so it wasn't really staying purple. Next up, we have the shade Utopia. And this is actually the one that I was the most excited about. Don't be deterred by the way that this swatch looks. I know it's kind of crazy at first, but once I get it to full coverage, you can see what is so exciting about this one. It's actually another tri-thermal polish, and it also has a scattering of iridescent flakes running throughout. And this one, when it's warm, it's a nice soft green color, which you can kind of see on my nails. And then when it's like room temperature, it becomes this really nice pink shade. And then when it's cold, it actually turns into a very vibrant deep purple. And I have just not seen a color combination like this before. I think it is so funky and different. And I feel like a lot of times with color shifting polishes, the shift is somewhat expected, but I would really never expect a green polish to turn into purple or pink. So I feel like that was just one of the really cool things about this. And you can see for the most part, I think on me, this one would kind of stay a little bit pink, but then as that color shifts around with the temperature, it'll turn either green or purple. Next up, we have the shade Tides, and this one is another one that has that subtle holographic sparkle as well as a really nice iridescent flake running throughout. And this one's really fun. When it is warm, it's a nice soft purple color, and then when it's cold, it's a really intense rich blue color. And I was really into this one. I love both of the color shifts. It was a little bit more subtle of a change in color than some of the other ones, but I just really thought that that iridescent flake running throughout was so beautiful and fun. And this color, for some reason, it kind of reminds me of butterflies. I'm usually not a big butterfly fan, but lately I've kind of changed my mind on them and I've been liking them a little bit more, so that made me like this polish a lot more. And I feel like I could definitely do some cool butterfly wing nail art with these, but that is a very specific to me thought. Aside from that, I do think the polish is really pretty, and like I said, I just really like both colors that it ended up being. Even though it's a little bit more on the subtle side, it's just both very pretty options. And last but definitely not least, we have the shade Mutation, and this one is another tri-thermal polish, and this is another one that has that subtle scattered hollow running throughout. And as you can see from the polishes that I picked out, I am very much into the tri-thermal idea here. I think that is such a fun concept, and I really wanted to flesh out my collection of thermals and have a lot more tri-thermals, and I know that Beau Polish is one of the brands that's really known for doing that. But anyway, this color shifts from, when it's warm, a nice gray color into a turquoisey deep teal kind of shade when it's tepid, and then when it is cold, it's actually a black polish here. So definitely a very cool and interesting one. I do love the color shift that goes into black. I think that's really interesting, but I just love that this one changes from being grayscale from cold to warm into this sort of medium bluish shade. I just think that's really unique. So I was really excited about this one, and I definitely wasn't disappointed once I saw it on my nails. It was a lot of fun to play around with and watch that shift happening. So here are all of the polishes together. That top row has the two flash reactive polishes, and then I also have that multi-chrome, which I wanted to show you guys a comparison of it on its own versus over black, because you can technically wear it either way. Like I said, I personally prefer it over black, but it's really up to you. And then the bottom two rows are all of my color shifting ones. So I was definitely intrigued with a lot of these tri-thermals, and as you can see, I definitely have a preference in terms of what I look for in a thermal. I like these nice pinky shades a lot. You can definitely see a lot in there. I also like a good purple, so you see a lot of that as well. But I just think they're really fun to play around with. Thermals are definitely a really cool way to do your nails, and it's also really fun to do nail art using them because the nail art itself can kind of change. One thing that you guys ask me a lot in the comments is how long thermal nail polish lasts for, like in the bottle before it settles into one color. That really depends on how you store it. I always store my polishes in a cool dark drawer where they're not really affected by sunlight or by strong temperatures, either cold or hot. So I've had mine last for up to a year or longer, but I believe the average on that is 6 months. And I tend to find that my polishes, when they do eventually settle into one color and stop doing that temperature shift, they tend to settle into the cool version of the polish. So just something to keep in mind when you're ordering them. So yeah, those are all of the new polishes. We had a lot to go over today, but I'm really just into this thermal vibe. So I wanted to show you guys all my new thermals. And then those two crazy flash reactive colors, I just think they're so much fun, especially in the summer, because like I said, you can get a lot of that crazy sparkly reflectiveness in the sunlight as well. It's definitely not as pronounced in the sunlight, but it's still very crazy bright. So like I said, I got all of these polishes from Lolly Polish, which is an international distributor. The polishes come in 11 milliliter bottles and they retail for $12 USD each. And you can also use my discount code Kelly to get 10% off your whole order. And that also includes the Lolly Polish brand of polishes, which is another brand that I have been reviewing lately and absolutely loving. So I'll link one of the collections up in the cards so you guys can check that out. But yeah, overall, I'm just really excited about these. It's not necessarily a new collection. The two reflective ones are newer polishes, but the rest are just random ones that I've been wanting to pick up because, like I've been saying, I am just really in a thermal mood lately. I'm having so much fun with all of the color shifting. I feel like they're a lot of fun to wear in the summer because, especially if you're like going in a body of water, then your nails are gonna change based on how cold the water is. But I think they're also really fun to wear in the winter. It's always funny to see like which of my nails stay the cold color and which of my nails stay the warm color just based on like how cold my fingers are. So I just have a lot of fun with those. And I feel like the Bow Polish ones are some of the more unique thermals that I've seen before. I feel like they do very interesting color shifts, especially with those tri-thermals. I just feel like they're a very rare thermal coloring set. A lot of brands I feel like just do more basic color shifts, but I just feel like those are really fun, and a lot of times they have like extra shimmers and glitters and flakes in there that just make them really unique. But yeah, that is it for my review, but I would love to hear from you guys. What do you think of the two new flash reactive colors? Are you planning on picking them up? Are you interested in the thermals, or do you already have them? Let me know in the comments. We can chat about it. If you enjoyed my swatch and review videos, please give this one a thumbs up. It lets me know I'm doing a good job. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribing. I put out new videos every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday. Huge shout out to my Cosmic Admirals on Patreon, Amanda M, Braxton Scott, Rainbow J, and Jessica Taylor. I really appreciate your support, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. Today's fun fact question comes from Patreon supporter Christina, and Christina wants to know, what's your favorite board or card game? By the way, Christina says, we enjoy Uno so much that when we spot a new one, we bring it home to play. And Christina's favorite version is Uno Flip, which I've never heard of before, but it sounds fun. But this is actually a funny and timely question because I feel like prior to everything that happened last year, I wasn't really big on board and card games. I definitely played them occasionally, but there wasn't one that stood out in my mind that was like a game that I play all the time. But additional extra fun fact, Ryan, my boyfriend who I live with, and I both work from home now, so we always eat lunch together. And while we eat lunch, we always play card games now. It's just like our thing that we have now been doing for like a year and a half. So when we first started doing it, we were always playing Gin, which I feel like is a very fun card game. But for the last, I want to say like year, we have been playing Crazy Eights, which I had never played before. It's definitely like a fun and very simple game, but it is for some reason the most entertaining lunch game that we have ever played. Like, we've tried other games before. We always end up going back to Crazy Eights because it's just so much fun to play. We always like are screaming at each other like when one of us just has to like pick up a million cards. It's just a really fun time. But yeah, it's just funny that you asked that because prior to this, I would have been like, I don't know, there's not really any games that I play, but now I can definitively say Crazy Eights, that's the game. All right, that's it. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.